Hi, this is one of my new fast forward models I've been working on in the last couple of years. The rounded pin with the fuller nose. There's a few different companies doing a similar type board. It's an old idea which has just been rehashed a bit. A few of my team riders have got this board and are absolutely loving it. Now, as you can see with the rocker, it's got an extremely flat rocker like we used in the mid 80s. Just a bit of a variance now in the bottom shape where we have a single concave all the way through opposed to the V like in the 80s. But this board basically is fast, but with the outline very forgiving. Now, we'll just go and have a quick look at the rest of the board. Now, I've still got a bit of thickness in the tip of the board here, so it's very well balanced, okay? It's not this thinned out tail or anything, it's really well balanced. So when you're standing on the tail, it just doesn't drop down too much, but it's got a nice even thickness all the way through, and there's that flat entry curve with a nice bit of thickness right through to the tip. Now, the other thing about this board, I'll just get the bottom stick there and we'll have a look at the bottom shape. It's just got a really basic bottom shape, just a slight single concave, the nose working through to the center, 1/8 inch concave, working through between your front and back foot, and then starting to fade out as we get towards the back foot. Now that's the most basic bottom shape you can have, but the idea behind it is, because the rail line and the stringer line are both base very similar, there's not too much happening which makes the board do anything unpredictable. Basically, you stand on this board, you just get speed straight away. The outline and the pin tail allows it to handle really sucky situations. If it had a square tail, it would probably slide out heaps more. The pin tail holds it in. Lots of curve in the outline, which enables it to do all the cutbacks, maneuvers, whatever maneuvers you want to do. Now you can see the fin set up. Comes with a tri, comes with the quad fins as well. So if you want to ride it as a quad, basically these days, we've always got that option in our boards, okay? At the moment, one of my team riders has got this. This is her second one because she loved the first one so much in case she breaks it when she goes to Fiji or something. She wanted a sparey. So we've just found that this board is really, really easy to ride. Now, there's no set rule. Some companies say it's best to be ridden 2 or 3 inches shorter than your normal board. This board's, it's sort of not like that. When you get a custom board, we talk about what size you'd like. If you're a bigger guy or girl, overweight or something like that, need more flotation, then you ride this board in slightly bigger sizes. But if you're a lightweight surfer, not carrying any extra weight or anything like that, of course, then we ride these ones shorter. But the whole thing about getting the custom board is having this so it works just right for you. But this is the board for getting lots of speed if you're wanting to do those air tricks and all that, or even just big, hard roundhouse cutties, everything. It's a good all-round board. It doesn't completely replace the normal thruster, my fast forward, but it's a board which a lot of surfers are finding. Having this forward area here is just making it a lot more forgiving. And for a lot of people that aren't surfing every single day, only the weekends, sometimes, you know, having that bit more forgiveness just makes that surf a bit more fun. Anyway, this is one of my fast forwards.